Hello and welcome to a Brit Reacts to Bollywood. I'd like to welcome you, my friends, from around the world and in India. And I'd like to say to you, Namaste, Assalamu Alaikum, and Sat Sri Akal Ji. And I want to make a special announcement. This coming Saturday, I will be doing a live stream with you, answering your questions, talking, responding to things, looking at Bollywood today, around 10 a.m. Delhi time. 10 a.m. Delhi time for about an hour. If a lot of you think 11 is preferable, please say in the comments, otherwise I'll be doing 10. And I'll be responding and interacting with you, and I'll be doing a whole bunch of things. And it'll be fun, it'll be real fun, speaking to people from India, from London. Can you believe it? Technology. Okay, today I'm looking at a song from the 100 Greatest Bollywood Songs, as voted for on BBC Asian Network, and today's is from the film NASEEB. Now look at that crazy poster. That's something else. Gives you a pretty good sense of how psychedelic, colourful and weird it is. And oddly, it's from 1981. Hindi language masala film, which I believe is a kind of mix of tragedy and comedy and stuff. It's produced and directed by Manmohan Desai, written by Kader Khan. It's a typical Manmohan Desai film with his regular star Amitabh Bachchan, our friend, and an ensemble cast including Hema, Malini, Rishi Kapoor, Shatrughan Sinha, Rina Roy, Kim Yashpal, Pran, Kader Khan, Amjad Khan, Prem Chopra, Shakti Kapoor, Amrish Puri, and Yusuf Khan. Whew! Music by Laxmikant Pyarelal. It was one of those rare movies which crossed 1 crore per territory and was a huge blockbuster. Whew! The plot is NASEEB, a story of destiny and fate begins with a lottery ticket. A drunken man who cannot pay his tab, he decides to sell his ticket to the waiter, Namdev. Namdev purchases his ticket with his 3 friends, Damu, Raghu and Jaggi. Using a system of drawing out the highest card to decide who keeps the ticket, Jaggi wins and the ticket stays with him. When the ticket turns out to be a winner, great plot, Damu and Raghu turn on the other two, murdering Jaggi and framing Namdev. Namdev goes on the run, but Raghu and Damu intervene and throw him over a bridge into a river. Namdev is presumed dead. However, he is rescued by Don, and no one is aware he's alive. 20 years later, Damu and Raghu have used their stolen lottery money to build a fabulous hotel and make millions, becoming very successful businessmen. Damu has used a share of his money to send his youngest son, Vicky, to school in England. They have even employed Namdev's oldest son, Johnny, Amitabh Bachchan, Vicky's best friend, as a waiter in the hotel. By coincidence, or by fate, Johnny and Vicky fall in love with the same beautiful singer, Miss Asha. Julie is a childhood friend of Vicky's who's in love with him, but he only sees her as a friend. When Johnny discovers this, he and Julie sacrifice their own love to ensure that Vicky and Asha get together. At the same time, Johnny's younger brother, Sunny, Rishi Kapoor, has fallen for Asha's younger sister, Kim. Kim and Asha happen to be daughters of Jaggi, the man Namdev supposedly murdered. Namdev returns soon after and plans to take revenge against Damu and Raghu for separating him from his sons Johnny and Sunny. The lives of all these characters become intertwined, and NASEEB becomes a poignant story about love, friendship, sacrifice, deceit, revenge, and above all, destiny. Whew, that is a crazy story. And I really like the surprising mix of high drama and mistaken identities. It's almost farce, the amount of characters there are. I really like that. So let's take a look at this song. The song is Mer NASEEB MEIN. Apparently it's very popular. Let's find out. Oops. Look at that. Oh, it's so psychedelic. It's a very surreal round of applause. Oh, I love it. Look at that set. It's so pink. Here comes Amitabh. great shot to him. This is really funny. She looks a spectacle. She's beautiful. That shot to Amitabh was great, wasn't it? This is serious glamour for the early 80s. Ooh! He's so funny. So it's all about destiny. Uh-oh. Was he one of the criminals? He's doing a purely comic turn. So he's like a clown. The lovable everyman. Really surreal. What a performance. This is an interesting insight into that world of prosperous higher society and middle class India in that period. The characters you meet. Look at the guy with the sunglasses in the back. Woo! These are really interesting people. It's still quite 70s, that style. It's a good tune. Your parents would be going mad at this right now. Wow, what a sight. That's a shot. That's the shot, ladies and gentlemen. Oh! She's a good performer. She's got really good energy. I like her energy. Nice. Real comedy here, how much she's working. It's such an interesting farcical energy, comedy. Nice. It's a real cliche, the idea of that nightclub performance as part of the plot, where you have this female character, desired and glamorous, and the underdog male character who kind of has this will-they-won't-they relationship with her. Very interesting. Here he is! How cute. I mean, she looks great. I mean, the voice, the vocal performance, I'll have to check who did that. Lovely voice, isn't it? I could listen to her voice for hours. It's so... elevated. Everybody! It's a really melodious voice. There they are. I love the audience. A slice, a peek into the past, into prosperous society at that time. Ah, This is very much like Jawani Janiman. Beautiful. I mean, the first video I watched, Jawani Janiman, I think is how you pronounce it, was a very similar concept. Amitabh was there. It was a nightclub performance in a hotel or something. The beautiful lady was singing and he was sort of watching her admiringly from the side. There was comedy. There was a comedy waiter. Very similar. I think that voice is just extraordinary. And let me check who that is, actually. Lata Mangeshkar. I think it's Lata Mangeshkar. Just an extraordinary voice. Lovely melodious tune. Lakshmikant Pyarelal. Extraordinary. Just a really memorable tune that would stick with you for a while. And I can imagine a lot of people grew up with that in their youth, hearing their parents listening to that. It's a real nostalgic, beautiful, romantic piece. All about destiny, all about what is meant to be. Am I meant for you? Are you meant for me? As part of this wider plot. So it's got a double meaning. And I love that kind of storytelling and visual storytelling. And some of the performance was really beautiful there. And really silly and joyful and playful and of the sort of 70s, 80s. And I just love it. I love that kind of tongue-in-cheek, lightweight, but beautifully written and performed material. Let me know what you think, guys. Any info on Lata Mangeshkar? Anything about Amitabh or anybody like that? I'd be really interested to hear. Again, I will be here on Saturday, live streaming, 10 a.m. If most of you say 11, I'll do 11. But I'll be here most likely 10 a.m. and I will have a bunch of interactive fun to play with you and I'll be chatting to people and I'll definitely be answering questions and I'll even try some Indian cuisine if you have anything to suggest. I will be here for an hour. Hit that like button, hit that subscribe button. I've also got a Patreon where you can support me and I can provide you with bespoke, personalized material and performance of my own and things like that. Continue with me on my journey. This is your Brit reacting to Bollywood with very much appreciation for your feedback. Ta-ta for now.